Hello everyone, I'm Chad Smith, and today we're going to talk about connecting to the iFIX OPC UA server through or via the IGS OPC UA client. So to do that, we're going to go into the IGS configuration. We're going to go ahead and create a new channel and select, and this is something you need to make sure you include when you install, as one of the options when you install the IGS is the OPC UA client. We go through the different options. We'll just accept all the defaults for now. And in here, we want to specify the iFIX URL. So to get that, we go to the iFIX OPC UA server configuration tool. You can see that our endpoint is here. You might want to double check that your security policy supports the same policies as the IGS, in this case we're going to make sure that basic 256 is enabled. We'll save that, and we'll go ahead and copy in that endpoint for the iFIX server. So you can see we want to connect through the basic 256, and we're going to go through the sign and encrypt in this case. And we'll just accept defaults here, and to log in to the iFIX server, you need your credentials, which you enter here. And we'll finish there. And so this is popping up and saying, hey, I don't trust this iFIX server. Do you want to go ahead and trust it? And I'm going to say yes. So now the iFIX or the IGS client trusts the iFIX OPC UA server. We'll have to make sure that we trust the client as well, or the server trusts the client as well. Now for us to generate that certificate on the server side for the client to be able to trust it, we need to try to connect. So we're going to try to go into the create a device in the IGS configuration. We're going to go all the way down here, selecting all the defaults. Now if we go to select all the imported items, we say, whoa, it doesn't let you do that. Why doesn't it let you do that? It says we don't trust that certificate. So if we go back over to here and refresh, you can see that on that connection, we looked at the client certificate, didn't trust it, so we put it in our rejected list. This is in the iFIX UA server config tool. Now I can go say, I trust that client, and if we try to go back into and add a device again, and now we can browse it. Now it's trusted, we can browse it, we can see the tags inside of the iFIX server, and we can go ahead and finish that, and you can see that it added those tags at that level, and we're getting that value. So that's really all there is to it. You just connect and give it the right endpoints, the right authentication, and make sure that both the client and server trust each other. Thanks for watching.